my main role that I would like to portray in is probably assistant.
The man dream.
Off the bench, probably 6 assists a game. That would be a set role for me that I'm looking forward to this season.
And we don't have a lot of time left, but while we're talking about assists and whatnot, is there someone, maybe one of the point guards in the playoffs right now that you think is going to take them all the way?
Ready open mics, ready music under, get ready to cue the anchors to camera two.
But as far as assistant, I like Chris Paul. Chris Paul, got it.
All right, that's it for Mike Robinson. Thank you so much for coming here tonight, Mike. And that will do it for athletes.
Open mics, take them, music under.
After the break, one of our tracks.
Ready server four with sound, ready close mics.
And the finish line is within sight.
And we learned about an athlete and CNN hero who is
half woman, half, we'll just stick around to find out.
Roll it, roll it. Ready, camera one, ready. Oh, I'll see you in a second. Ready, camera one, ready, close mics. Camera one, zoom out all the way for the bump.
When you're out there, there's no telling what you'll
find. Right there, thanks.
I'll see you in a second. See it.
Okay. I'm still gonna see
you. Oh, look at you.
There are some moments only the forest can inspire.
Ready, open their mics.
At discovertheforest.org.
Take them, open mics.
So taking a break from
ready
sports here, I understand
sound.
You have a date tonight.
This
mic?
Is a sports show. We don't take breaks.
No.
Okay, anyways, I like how we're wearing green.
Wait.
I'm happy you found the tie.
Okay,
it's
wait,
Earth Day.
You're going from
can
date
we talk
to
about
Earth
Day?
Day?
The Earth Day is
close
more important than my life.
Close
Earth Day is more
roll it.
Me and my boy Matt
dip,
had it good.
You have to make sure they're rolling it.
He had catnip that was off the hook.
Ready,
one
camera
day,
one.
He brings
camera
a girl
one, get your shot back really quickly. We're coming to you.
She's allergic to cats.
Zoom in, camera
every
one.
Every sneeze was a nail in my coffin. Now I'm in a shelter.
Tilt down.
It's
a
decent,
bit. Yeah.
But
yeah, zoom in.
They don't even have Wi-Fi.
Get ready to cue Alex to camera one. Be still, camera one. We're coming to you. Gotta be still. Open mics. Take them.
UM runner Henry DeLaus, maybe
sound,
just a sophomore, but he has some big dreams. DeLaus' main aspiration is to compete in the Olympic Games in Rio, and he already has some Olympic experience, having won a bronze medal in the Nanjing Youth Olympic Games in 2014. Chantel Batista has more.
Roll it.
DeLaus,
take it, close mics.
Representing
one,
a nation who know a thing or two about 400-meter running.
He's a Miami Hurricane, a Bahamian national athlete, and an aspiring Olympian. Sophomore Henry DeLaus brought home a bronze medal in the 2014 Nanjing Youth Olympic Games in China. And this year, his one goal is to race his way to Rio.
Well, 2016 so far to date is probably the biggest year I have. First of all, I have Griffith Games, that's probably in March. I have World Juniors, and then I have Nationals for college, and then Olympic Trials. So Rio is the biggest thing on the board for me, and I personally want to run 45 seconds this year.
Henry's love and dedication towards track began at the young age of 8. Little did he know his parents had a long-term plan in mind.
My parents put me in the track and field. They was trying to look at long-term. They wanted me to go off to college. They knew college was expensive, so they knew they couldn't afford it, so they was trying to find a way in sports to get a sports scholarship to go to college.
DeLaus met a University of Miami recruiter 2 years ago at an international meet in Ukraine. He came to the University of Miami feeling confident that the track program and coaches will get him to where he wants to be.
He told me he liked the way I ran. He said he's interested and he wanted to keep in contact. And now I'm here at the University of Miami. Before I leave here, I want to leave my mark. I want people who come after me to, you know, when they come here, they see, oh, hey, who is this guy? I want them to know my name. Before I leave, I want to break the 400-meter record. Here
ready, mics, ready, camera
we'll
three.
Have to wait
you're
and see where the next few months
three.
Will lead our fellow Hurricane as the road to Rio continues. Reporting for UMTV, I'm Chantel Batista.
Open mics, taker.
It's official. Instead of just
ready,
seeing the Lakers logo,
ready,
the Warriors
mics.
Logo, or the Bulls logo, advertisements will now be displayed on NBA jerseys starting in 2017-2018 season. And the move is creating controversy. The head-to-head crew is here to debate the change. Guys?
Roll it. Take it. Close mics.
Hi, everyone, and welcome to the last edition of Head-to-Head for the semester. I'm your host, Meredith Sloan, here with Chloe Harrison and Mercedes Espina. So the NBA announced that they will allow on-jersey advertising starting next year. Chloe, how How do you feel about this decision?
I like it. Marketing is a game of perception, and with perception come visuals. It's going to be a really small logo on the jersey. It's not going to be obnoxious like the WNBA or soccer per se. Rather, it's going to be like the NFL when they practice. The Houston Texans use Xfinity, the Denver Broncos use GMC. It's concise, and it's going to be projected to the masses, and it's going to be on the most important part of the game, which are the players.
What do you think, Mercedes?
But why does the NBA need to market something that's already a brand, not only here in the United States, but globally? I think that bringing in an extra couple million dollars on top of their $24 billion broadcast revenue is just excessive. Putting advertisements on the players is just making them walking billboards, as if they aren't that already, for their own, you know, sponsorship deals. And I think that the fans are just going to get overloaded with advertisements, not only in the stadium, but at home on TV, if they're watching it on their phones, if they're watching it online. It's just an overload, and at some point it's just going to become an advertising game over an actual sports event. And I think it's just a step in the wrong direction.
Well, how do you think these advertisements will change the game?
Well, I already think that the NBA is a little showboaty. I think it really takes away from, you know, the transition between college basketball and the NBA. Because in college, they're playing for the love of the game. It's something they've been playing since they were young. They want to be playing. There's no real money incentive. But once you get to the NBA, there's sponsorship deals. There's team deals. You're just getting billions and billions of dollars thrown at you over and over and over again. And it starts to become playing for money rather than playing for the actual love of the game.
Do you think it'll change the game, Chloe?
I don't think it's going to change it that much. Like I said, the logos are really small. They're recently used in the 2016 All-Star game, so it's not going to make that much of a difference. Also, the logos aren't going to appear on the jerseys that they sell to vendors, so it's not going to change the game much. It's just going to make the NBA grow as a brand and bring more sponsors to the game itself.
Well, that's all the time we have for tonight. Now back to you guys at the desk.
Take them. Music
Thanks,
under.
Guys. Coming up, what's cute and has killer soccer field? Besides my man
Ready,
Cristiano Ronaldo,
with sound.
Of course.
Ready, close mics.
We'll show you after the break.
And on this week's Not Play of the Day, I show you guys a routine save that went so wrong. Stick around.
Roll it, dip to it, close mics.
What do people wear?
Clothes.
That's right. So it's important to learn how to dress yourself. Here's how it's done. Shirt, underwear, pants, socks, shoes. Underwear, always first, name tag on the back. Then pants and shirt. Go ahead and put this on. Now with the shirt, you want to make sure the first button's right or you have to start all over again, okay? Socks left on left, right on right. Tying the shoes, we're going to take the laces, we're going to cross them over, we're going to turn around where the bunny goes down in the hole, pull it tight, and bunny ears. Got it?
Most parenting is hard to do in just 2 minutes. But 2 minutes twice a day making sure they brush is easier, and it could help save them from a lifetime of tooth pain.
Everybody has a dream. Mine was to see the ocean. And with a little help.
Ready, open mics. Ready, server three with music under. Ready, cue them. Open mics. Roll it. Take it. Cue them.
NHL playoff action, Capitals against Flyers. Routine dumping
Ready,
by the Capitals
one.
And wait a second, that just went in? Look at this again here. I'm thinking the Flyers goalie Steve Mason forgot how to hockey for a second. This little dump in here goes off the Capitals defenseman and somehow it finds its way in. That looks like a routine save, man. You gotta do that. You're making millions of dollars. Look at this, it goes five hole. How can you do that? Costly decision here. Capitals wind up winning this game.
Roll it. Roll it.
But
take
now
it.
Here, we're going to switch it over to the play of the day.
Ready,
my Cubs,
three.
Boy, did I love this game. Cubs, Cincinnati, Jake Arrieta, he's on his A game right now. The defending Cy Young champion here, striking out red after red after red. He's working with a sizable lead here. Look at it, it's 13-0 going into the bottom of the eighth inning. And he's still got his nice stuff. And hang on
you
a minute,
ready to cue,
he's got
to
a
camera
no
three.
Hitter. Look at, he's got ice in his veins. Look at that concentration, folks. The fans, they're going nuts right now. Phones are out. They're ready to see history. And history, they saw. Routine pop-up, Jason Hayward calling him off, makes the catch. That's a no-no, folks. Second no-hitter for Jake Arrieta in two seasons. Grandpa Rossi's
Tell
loving
Christina
it. The
look
team
at her
is
camera.
Loving it. What a great day for my Cubs. They're killing it right now. This is your play of the day.
Fade music, taker, cure. Fade
During
music.
The University of Miami's Week of
Ready,
Wellness,
server two with
the
sound.
School
Ready,
welcomed
close
Robin Benincasa, one of the most decorated adventure racers in the world. And after her time as a world-class athlete, she decided to turn to charity, where she became a CNN hero. Danny New has the story.
Roll it.
The following year, I was able to pull that record off.
Robin Benincasa wasn't your average world-class athlete. She won world championships and broke Guinness World Records doing things like climbing the Himalayan peaks and kayaking for days at a time. in a team sport called adventure racing. But eventually, all that caught up with her.
After, 20 years of endurance sports, from Ironman triathlons to, literally 16 years of these ultra-endurance races, I had run out of cartilage in my hips. And so over the last 6 years now, I've had six hip replacements.
But she didn't give up there. And besides returning to new sports, she also turned to building a new team with women she's never met but would never forget.
And what I decided to do was kind of take that energy and that came from the endurance side of my life, the adventure side of my life, and say, you know what, I want to help other women to live an adventurous dream as part of their recovery and show them how strong and amazing they are.
If you want to come with us, you don't have to all rush the stage to sign up. I see that you're just at the edge of your seats. How do I get involved?
Her project, the Athena Foundation, would go on to earn her a spot as a CNN hero for taking groups of 30 to 40 women with medical hardships to things that they had never imagined, like hiking the Grand Canyon in a day and biking from Key Largo to Key West. And that's how the University of Miami found her.
So the team that plans the Week of Well-Being works with our partners, and we look for inspiring people. So we kind of scour the resources around and look for people that will come and motivate and inspire and that really reflect, I think, the values that we have here, right? So diversity, teamwork, creativity, and Robin really brought all of that together today.
And she's inspiring everyone, even people not in the program.
I'm a mother of two kids, and so we're probably going to try and run a 5K this year. That'll be my goal for the year.
And now Robin will just keep on going. And even if her body starts to wear and tear, it doesn't matter because her spirit's not going
ready
anywhere.
Up mic, ready to
old
out.
Only
to
happens
one.
When you run out of dreams.
Camera one, we'll use them in a tiny
and
bit.
And goals and adventures.
Hurry,
and,
hurry,
that
hurry,
will
hurry.
Never happen.
Right there, right there.
Danny New, Coral Gables, UMTV.
Open mics, take them, cue them.
There's always a debate about who is
ready,
currently the best soccer player in the world. Some say Messi,
no
others
sound.
Say Neymar, but this week the internet has come to a consensus. Cristiano Ronaldo is the best soccer player in the world.
Roll it.
The 2-year-old soccer playing pup became a viral sensation this week after a video of him skillfully dribbling surfaced on the web. The dog's actual name is Alfie, and he was adopted recently from the Dogs Trust charity. His new family, the Simpkins, were shocked to discover Alfie's skills, especially as they haven't even trained him yet. Watch out, Cristiano Ronaldo. He's coming for you.
Well, this is it, Alex. After a whole semester of anchoring together, we have come to the end.
No, I'm pretty sad, Christina. You know what? Even though you roasted me a lot, I'm going to miss it.
I'm going to miss you too, genuinely.
Well, so long, everyone.
Good night, everyone.
Zoom out slowly, Portia.